air quality, as is water quality, is one of the foundations of all life. All the vegetation, the trees, the birds, the bats, the insects, the deer, the bear, all of the living things really depend on the quality of the air. So it's really important for us to understand what impacts the air that's being breathed by all living things have on their health, including our human health, our visitors, and our staff. Devil's Postpile is located in the Central Sierra. So I often think of it as the heart of the Sierra. So we're about midway in between Yosemite and Sequoia Kings Canyon. Well, we're really fortunate to have a partnership with Pacific Southwest Research Station, which is the research arm of the U.S. Forest Service Department of Agriculture. And this collaborative partnership actually started about 5 years ago when we recognized that we're in a location in the Sierra Nevada that's affected by a lot of the air movements that are coming from the west side, of course, but also coming up the drainage of the upper middle fork of the San Joaquin River.
In our 2007 and 2008 research, we found that the highest air pollution in this area is when the air pollution masses are coming from the San Francisco and Sacramento area, and they sweep down the California Central Valley and then get into the Sierra through the San Joaquin River drainage. Our past studies show that there are some days when air pollution is affecting this area and we have exceedances of ozone concentrations. Exceedance of the air pollution standard, primary air pollution standard, it means that it potentially may affect health of people. So we are very concerned about all the visitors and also staff in the Devils Postpile National Monument. This year's study is kind of a continuation of that effort, but with the main objective of looking at the effects of local pollution from those shuttle buses on air quality and what we could do as the Forest Service and National Park Service in regard to protect air quality in the area and propose some measures which would keep this very important national monument clean from the point of view of air and also safe to people from the point of view of preventing them from inhaling excessive amounts of air pollutants. So we use passive samplers which are measuring concentrations of ozone, nitrogen oxides, ammonia and nitric acid. This instrument, which is operated by colleagues from UC Merced and Forest Service Management Branch, is called EBAM and measures concentrations of particulate matter. So particulates smaller than 2.5 micrometers in diameter, which are very toxic to people, and particulate matter which is smaller than 10 micrometer in diameter, so-called PM10, which is also a criteria pollutant. This information will be used to tell the public and tell the land and air quality managers what air quality we have in this particular site, Devil's Postpile National Monument. And it will tell the managers of the monument what levels of pollution they have, if the levels of pollution is high enough to be concerned about public health. So far, we have data on ozone and nitrogen oxides. So far, it means from the beginning of June until more or less mid-July, and concentrations of those two categories of pollutants are not very high, but we'll be continuing our research until the end of September. So we have to have information from the whole season in order to tell what air quality in this particular place of the National Monument is during the whole season when there is many tourists and visitors coming to the park.
We also realize, in addition to air pollution, that we also have some other changes we need to be monitoring with the climate changing and unfolding and rapidly progressing, perhaps in sensitive areas like this. It's going to be really important to understand what changes are occurring so we can figure out where the mitigations are that we can take as a National Park Service and as a society to protect these precious places. And then as managers, what type of adaptation strategies that we would need to implement in the land. So The partnership between the U.S. Forest Service, the Pacific Southwest Research Station, the National Park Service, our academic partners, is really critical for us to sustain these beautiful places for both all living things here and now and future generations.